Okay, it's October, so I want to make something that's both spooky and spectacular. So what would I call that? I got it! Spec-spookular! Wait, no, ugh. This is brand new Relic, the monthly series where I finally play the classic games I never got to try. First off, some major plot spoilers for Silent Hill 2, so if you've managed to know nothing about this game, I mean, samesies. Also, content warning for sexual assault, incest, and self-harm. When it comes to both the greatest games of all time and the greatest horror games of all time, there's one title that keeps popping up. Okay, there's another title that keeps popping up. No, there's another. No. No. No, why would you think that? Oh, wait, go back one. There it is. I've heard that this game is one of the very best ever made by many people whose opinions I trust, and some people that I don't. When I first got a PlayStation 2, big thanks to my friend Emily for that, Silent Hill 2 was one of the first games that I bought on eBay. And then, it sat on my shelf. Here's the thing with me and horror. I love it. Love it. And also, I hate it. You know that feeling when the roller coaster first starts moving and you say to yourself, "Let me off, let me off, let me off"? That's how I approach horror. When it's done well, it's brilliant. And I hate it. So I've been hesitant to sit down and give this one the attention it deserves. But now, it's time. But first, I know that this game sits between Silent Hill 1 and Silent Hill 3, neither of which I've played. In fact, I've only played one Silent Hill game, and it's this one. In which, I'm sorry, the scariest moment isn't this, but this. Never getting that one out of my head. Story-wise, I know that the silence is broken because James Sunderland's life is shattered when his young wife Mary suffers a tragic death. 3 years later, a mysterious letter arrives from Mary beckoning him to return to. And I know that Silent Hill 2 is often touted for its excellent writing, such as in this pair of tweets where Will Tally compared Watch Me Jump to its brilliance. Yes, this is me humble bragging about my game, and yes, I liked both tweets. What of it? What was I talking about? Right, yes, Silent Hill 2. Let's boot up the PS2. That's right, no emulator this time. And let's get started. Ah, I remember when that logo meant something. Then someone on the loading screen needs to wipe their feet, and we meet James Sunderland, who definitely looks like his life is shattered. And scene. We find out how close a camera can get to a urinal, and then I'm already stuck trying to get out of this room. Off to a great start.
We spent the whole day there. Just the two of us, staring at the water.
And I find out that James doesn't have to run very far to get winded. Just like me. Wait, what was that noise? Not cool, game. Then we reach a save point, which James says feels like someone's groping around in your skull. Is that what saving feels like to video game characters? If so, Ellie must constantly be having headaches. That explains why she's so cranky. And then we're already in a graveyard, really just getting that one out of the way. We tell this woman that we're lost, and
lost?
This voiceover acting is really something. She's looking for her mother, but
I thought my father and brother were here, but I can't find them either.
So you're also looking for your father and brother. I just leave her in that graveyard, okay, bye, I guess. And then here we are, Silent Hill, celebrating 70 years of flowers. Clearly the map is telling me to go to Rosewater Park, despite, you know, the blood and the monsters. But I can't get there because of this impenetrable police tape. How can any one person get through that? And this completely normal cave-in, you know, the kind that destroys entire streets, totally standard. So I follow the blood trail to this tunnel where, oh, hi, can you tell me how to get to Rosewater Park? I get a wooden plank, which I swing with great enthusiasm, and a radio where someone on the other end really wants jam. And I'm back in town where see, this is why you wear a mask. Cool, took care of nope, 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 nope. Fortunately, I can just run past most of these guys. Hello, hi, good morning. We find a dead body who leaves such helpful tips like telling us he's dead. Very informative. I spend way too long trying to kill one bug. And then I need a key to get into this apartment, so I'm just going to nope, you cannot jump out from under a van like that. I get the key, head into the apartment, and someone forgot to pay the electricity bill. I literally can't see where I'm going, so I'm turning up the brightness. Yep, those lines look faint to me. But then I get a flashlight, finally, and nope. I hope someone filed a complaint against this landlord because this upkeep is atrocious. I try to grab a key when...
Ow! Hey, wait! Damn it.
This is why children are the worst. I find a handgun in a shopping cart, so I'm guessing it's from Walmart? And then this red monster is just staring at me, which is fine. That's fine. Everything's fine. You stick your arm in a perfectly normal hole. Ooh, butterflies. And then, nope, okay, game's over, everyone. I'd like to thank my Patreon supporters. Make sure to like and subscribe and... Okay, I can do this. So there's this monster with a pyramid for a head. I don't even know what you'd call that. Yeah, that's fair. No, James, don't shoot at it. That's not James. Just, no. Then we find a sightseeing brochure. Yeah, I think I'll pass. Thanks. And I try to leave, but... Oh, you think something's not right, James? Could it be the sentient mannequins and the guy with a pyramid for a head? So we explore some more and find... video games, everybody.
You're not friends with that red pyramid.
James is really cavalier when talking about everything that's happening here. Then we find out about a guy who stabbed himself with a soup spoon. Couldn't he use a more useful utensil? Like, you know, any other utensil? And yeah, I guess come to think of it, that guy might seem crazy. Then I perform the most boring stunt ever to get to the next apartment building, which is not much better. Oh hey, it's the lost lady, who, doesn't seem to be doing well. James asks a lot of questions, none of which is, could you put that knife down, please? She's officially my favorite character. You show off your pressed pennies, get a key that leads to another key, and- Nope, okay, episode's over, make sure to comment and follow me on Twitter and- Come on, Jeremy, you've barely started. Pyramid Head can't be that bad of a boss. And it's not! Hey look, it's the end of Blair Witch Project! So I finally leave the apartments and it's on to Rosewater Park when-
It was you, wasn't it? You're the one who stepped on my hand.
I don't know, maybe I did.
Yeah, children are the worst. Oh, what a fun mural! So then we reach the park when-
Mary?
But no, it's not your dead wife, it's...
My name is Maria.
See? Big difference. James is super cool with meeting the doppelganger of his dead wife, who is just...
So, the hotel was your special place, huh? I'll bet it was. You were gonna just leave me? I look like... Mary, don't I?
Yeah. But hey, the more the merrier, especially when she's as out of shape as I am. We try to make our way to a hotel, not for the reason you think. What's baby ad kids? And cool, the mannequins just fly at you now. But first, we have to stop at a bowling alley and...
I hate bowling.
That's why you don't want to go into an abandoned bowling alley? So I go in to find out that there's no bowling, but oh, good, these two.
This town is full of monsters. How can you sit there and eat pizza?
Don't listen to him, Eddie, I get it. We chase the girl through this place. Sure. And ooh, James has a drinking problem. Interesting. We follow her to a hospital. Oh, good. With perhaps the least helpful nurses I've ever seen.
It's just a hangover.
Ugh, been there. Yeah, just rest in the spooky hospital crawling with monsters, on a bed that looks like it's everything except comfy. I make my way to the roof where I find a diary and, hey, that's my birthday! Then of course Pyramid Head shows up.
Why are you so obsessed with me?
He knocks me down, but I get up again. You're never gonna keep me down. And then I start unlocking this rather locked box. We find a little girl who very easily dupes us.
It's further back, in the desk.
Children are the worst. And then we're shooting at swinging bodies, and I imagine this is not how James saw his Saturday going. And just when we thought the hospital couldn't get any worse, it gets worse. Ooh, an original Banksy. I try to get in the fridge like Indiana Jones, but I can't open the door, so instead I read some middle school poetry and learn what an ampule is. Neat. So then I- Oh, come on, Maria, don't sneak up on a guy like that.
Why didn't you try to save me? All you care about is that dead wife of yours.
This relationship is going great. Then we unlock a door by putting two rings on a 3D printed hand of a painted woman. I think you can buy that at Lowe's. And then I'm on a game show.
South of the lake is a deserted old neighborhood called South Vale. From there to Palevale, the central resort area northwest of the lake, there's only one road you can take.
Yeah, no thanks.
You're supposed to be the big man around here. How's a little girl like me supposed to help?
Don't play into gender norms, Maria. Then Pyramid Head chases us down a hallway and...
No!
Yeah!
I'll never forget you, weird doppelganger of my dead wife. I'm finally out of the hospital, and it's pitch black in Silent Hill, which is exactly what I was hoping for. And I'm told that if I want to see Mary, I should just die.
False. I'll go false.
So I head back to the park, no, your ad, and I get a key to the Historical Society. Because if there's one thing I want, it's to learn more about this terrible town. What are quiet cocktails? We get there and, okay, the nice landscape painting is gone, but this Hieronymus Bosch monstrosity is still here. And then we... Oh, I don't like that. You know what? I don't think finding Mary is worth it at this point. Your only choices for death were strangling or skewering? Why would you even ask me that? It turns out a wooden plank can break through a brick wall, and then... Hey, buddy.
Anyway, I gotta run.
You're going out there alone?
Yeah.
Eddie?
No, James, let Eddie go. And then we're in a prison. Awesome. We look at some art projects.
Hey, Burning Man!
Then we hang up some pictures and... What was that? Wait, this is a hangman scaffold? Did we just hang someone? Sorry. Hello? Haven't peed in a while. Not cool, person literally taking the piss. And I have a rifle now, which actually makes me more nervous. And then I open a hatch by using a lighter to melt wax to a horseshoe, which is the most LucasArts point and click this game has been so far. I jump down another hole, and I go through double doors that aren't on the map. This is fine, everything's fine, just a bunch of dead bodies in another hole. And how does James keep surviving all these jumps? We get in an elevator, which has a nice rhythm to it. Yes! And then, wait, Maria? Or is she Mary? She's being really coy for a dead person.
Don't you want to touch me?
Now's not the time, Maria Mary. I run around an architectural nightmare. Ooh, what a great knife! And then I stumble upon Lost Lady, who found her dad, I guess? Who's some weird monster that attacks with a door? I don't know what you'd call that. Not what I was expecting, but it works. And then-
You could just force me. Beat me up like... he always did.
Ooh, not a fan of this incest angle. Plus, I can't really listen to what anyone's saying because I'm trying to figure out what's going on with these walls. So then I keep exploring and- Oh, come on! Turns out these corpses have the very dignified purpose of being a puzzle. And then...
Maria?
Alright, Maria Mary, this isn't funny anymore. And then we're in an indoor graveyard, you know, one of those things, where I hop into my own grave like I'm Ebenezer Scrooge. I go down a hallway that- Oh, come on, seriously?
Maybe I am nothing but a fat, disgusting piece of shit.
Wow, Eddie's really going through some stuff, huh? Well, not anymore.
I killed a human being.
Yeah, you killed a human being. And you're over it. The long night is over and... Wow, we barely moved. Then it's a lovely day to go rowing and... Oh, we're at a hotel. I hope they have a continental breakfast. I get a map and... Waiting for you. Great. And oh, hi, Laura. Turns out my dead wife gave her a letter a week ago, but whatever, Laura, my wife gave me a letter too and... Why did her letter disappear? And are you sure you don't need toilet paper, James? Because there's no way you haven't soiled your pants. Then I collect a bunch of Disney Princess music boxes. Oh, these are gonna sell so well on eBay. Then I try to get in this elevator, which gets very upset with me because... One person allowance? I didn't think I'd put on that much weight. Turns out I have to unload my entire inventory. My entire inventory. How dare you, game. How dare you. So I go down the stairs and nope, 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 nope. But there's nowhere else to go, so yep, excuse me, I hate everything right now. Then I end up here. Of all the dive bars and all the abandoned hotels and all the haunted towns and all the world, she walks into mine. My Humphrey Bogart impersonation, spot on. Then I unload my music boxes, and yeah, you can dance to this. And here we go, I'm about to see who's waiting for me, and... It's no one, but there's a videotape that needs watching. Please be Men in Black, please be Men in Black. And hey, wouldn't you know it, it's a horror game where it turns out the protagonist killed a loved one and blocked it out of his memory. The videotape ends and do I die in 7 days? Is that how that works? James demonstrates that he has no idea how to talk to children. And we hear Mary's voice on the radio because sure, that's definitely real, right? This hotel just lost a couple stars. I listen to a bizarre audiobook, take the elevator to the basement, have one last conversation with Lost Lady, and-
Mama, why are you running away?
I think you have me mistaken for someone else. Also, clearly neither of them are worried about smoke inhalation.
It's hot as hell in here.
Yeah, James, there's a lot of fire. And then, I feel like you're trying to tell me something, game. So Maria Mary dies, again. James does his best impression of Platoon, and then we're fighting two pyramid heads, and... Well, that's one way to end a battle. Then I get two eggs. Ah, the continental breakfast. And the truth comes out in this hallway, and it's... pretty sad. Then it's Maria Mary again, and she's coming on real strong. So we break up with her, and she does not take it well. But we defeat her, and we're treated to the mercy-killing trope. And then...
Now, we can be together.
Oof. Then we read Mary's entire letter, which goes on for a while.
And so I wait, wrapped in my cocoon of pain.
I feel
so pathetic and ugly laying here. It's not that I'm getting better. It's just that this may be my last chance.
When I first learned that I was going to die, I just didn't want to accept it.
This letter's gone on too long.
And we end with a 2001 music video. Turns out that was one of six endings, and also apparently the game is inspired by Crime and Punishment, which I've never read. And now I don't need to. I played the video game. Pretty much everything. Silent Hill 2 constantly kept me uneasy. The sound design did a great job of warning me when danger was around, but then at the same time played with my expectations and preconceptions, making me think a hallway is dangerous when it wasn't. Yes, I hear the pounding, thank you. The look of the world was dark and murky, but unlike other games of the era, that actually played to its advantage. Not always being able to make out what I was looking at just helped to enhance the creepiness. That doesn't make navigation a chore, however. The maps were incredibly helpful, and I did appreciate that James turned his head whenever there was a monster or an item to gather, although it's not polite to stare, and this all worked together to create a very palpable foreboding. Even on an easier setting, I still found myself treading carefully at times, afraid of what was waiting in the darkness. It got so bad some nights that I would have to detox after the game by pretending I was pitching for the Phillies. Much better. The monster design was very effective. There are only a few variations here, but they never stopped freaking me out. And as for the humans, they're generic archetypes, blonde bombshell, goofy simpleton, the most annoying kid in the world, but they were all really memorable, landing in that sweet spot between campy and chilling. And while some of the voiceovers can be laughable,
Lost?
When it's on, it's really on.
And I struck out at everyone I loved most.
But of course, the thing I've heard the most about is its narrative, and that's what kept me moving forward. Puzzles are nice, combat is fine, but what I wanted was to unpack the mysteries. Find out who was messing with James and what was going on in this town. And like all of the best horror, not all of my questions were answered. The story leaps over the part of our brains that craves logic and goes instead straight for the part that feels terror and dread, which just makes me want to go back to it again and unpack more of what I saw. Though for such a compelling narrative, not everything landed with me. Which brings us to... While I love the way it plays with some tropes, others have not aged quite as well. My guess is that Silent Hill 2 was one of the first games, if not the first, to reveal that the horror is all in the protagonist's head and that the real monster is you. But pretty much every horror game since then has explored this idea, to the point that just finding out that James drinks too much was enough for me to see where the rest of the story was going. This also led to the very problematic trope of the mercy killing, which I've never enjoyed. And linking Ashley's trauma to sexual assault and incest was particularly troubling, not enhancing the story and, in fact, removing me from it. On top of that, the PlayStation 2 era controls can be a bit clunky and can make it hard to pick up that object that you're looking at. Okay, just... no, just... come on, just, there we go. But at the end of the day... Silent Hill 2 is fantastic, and definitely lives up to the hype. I'm so glad I finally gave this one a playthrough. While I don't see myself plunking down another 40 hours for Final Fantasy VII, I'm sure I'll be coming back to the town of Silent Hill for a second time. Though not for a while, I'd really like to sleep again without seeing-
Nope.
If you like the work I'm doing here, but you're like, hey, I want to see something different, then you're in luck. My Play D-Pad, about a AAA game developer going indie, will be receiving its world premiere at Theater Exile in Philadelphia as part of their 2020-21 season. And the best part is that it's digital, so no matter where you are, you'll be able to check it out. Performances are in December, and you can find out more info by visiting theaterexile.org. I'd like to thank my Patreon supporters, in particular Brianne Shaw, and everyone who signed up for the Palm Tree Panic tier and above, all of whom get to see this video 3 days early. I'm about to release the first poll that will decide a future episode, so if you'd like to participate and get other benefits like early access, shoutouts, and bonus content, support me! Or if you like what you see but don't have the funds, you can follow me on Twitter for updates. Is there another game that you think is scarier? Let me know in the comments and it might end up in a future episode. And of course, make sure to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell to find out when new videos are posted. My next episode takes us all the way back to 1990X to play a cult classic RPG. So until then, thank you so much for watching.